name is Vernisa.
Hey, y'all. This is Jen.
And this is our podcast, Speak Up. What's up, Jen?
Hey, girl.
How are you?
I'm doing so good. How are you?
I'm good. Glad we made it to episode 55.
Yo, I can't believe we're at 55 already.
Yes. For those of you that don't know, me and Jen are best friends, and we create this podcast to use our voices to motivate people to overcome life's challenges through self-love and respect.
As y'all know by now, self-love and respect are two things we're always going to talk about.
Yes, always. So today, our title is Don't Fall For It. Don't fall for it.
Don't fall for it.
Don't fall for what, though?
What are we talking about today, Nene?
Are we talking about potential? You know, potential will get you in trouble.
Oh, that's for sure. I think you and I both know that, right?
Don't fall for it. Y'all trying to fall for the potential, not the reality. That's what we're talking about today.
And I think that's killer. Like, just seeing what somebody could be, what could you hope be. For them to be. You know, that's the problem. Like, we just sometimes are so focused on seeing the good parts of a person that we just, you know, neglect all the other parts that they come with, that they may not even be the right person for us to be focusing on in the first place.
I think a lot of it too is what we wish they were, mm-hmm. as well, you know. So we'll make these like crazy scenarios in our mind, like, oh, they could be this, they could be that, maybe I show them this, they'll act like this. And honestly, when that reality hits, you're in for a wake-up call.
Yeah.
You know, and I think it's very dangerous to do that. And it's bad for our mental health as well. You know, obviously, we have to relate it back to self-love and inner peace. So potential with yourself or potential with the other person, don't fall for it.
Oof, man, because I've been there.
haven't we all?
Yeah. And you lying to yourself if you say you haven't been there at least once.
Yeah, something, come on. You know, liked a photo or something and was like,
Maybe.
Maybe, huh?
Yeah.
Nah, but what would you say, best friend, are some signs that you're falling for somebody's potential?
I think when, you know, it all comes from like repetitive behavior, right? But when you're seeing that somebody's showing you so many things and they're not living up to it, or like, let's say they're telling you, I promise I'll change, or I promise I'll get to this, I promise we'll lead somewhere, and blah blah blah, and then things don't ever actually end up changing, I would say is one of the signs. What would you say?
I would say the broken promises. Mm-hmm. I would say the question mark, like the curiosity. Mm. I think when we're dealing with someone's potential, like we think they can be, we're always in that question mark. Yeah. Wondering, you know, the wondering stage.
Mm-hmm.
And I think none of it is really concrete in your face, you know, that's because true. it's something that's like in your mind the whole time.
Bro, ain't that the truth? Yeah. I mean, there's obviously so many signs, you know, that you could start looking at. But I think, yeah, you brought up that really good point of confusion, the wondering. That's the number one thing where even if y'all heard that quote that says, like, no answer is an answer.
Ooh.
I think that's one of the big signs, too, that you're falling for their potential. Like, they kind of stringing you along, feeding you those crumbs along the way. And it doesn't all have to be bad. Sometimes we create that potential in our heads, thinking that this person should be a certain way or whatever. But it's just paying attention to those things. And, like, if you're left with more questions than answers, the longer you deal with somebody, that's a red flag. You need to start looking at maybe you're falling for that potential instead of their actual reality.
I like that. I think too, you know, if you catch yourself wanting more for them than they want for themselves, like if you're always trying to convince them to level up, you know, don't get me wrong, something wrong motivating people, inspiring people, you know, I think we're, as humans, we should be doing that for people every day. You know, that should, you know, I think that's something we all should be doing. But I think if it's at the point you're doing the dirty work for them, like, you know, you're stressing about it more than they are, that's you falling for somebody's potential because they don't even see it. So it's like, if they don't see that with themselves, what makes you think they're gonna change?
That's true.
I just want to say, falling for the potential isn't enough.
Were y'all listening?
Speaking up tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I'm gonna keep referring back to my experiences because I think, yeah, that's number one thing that I learned. Like, potential, you can waste a whole 2 years on somebody thinking that you're actually going to go somewhere with them, and they keep promising you this and that, and maybe you even keep promising them something too, and it's just never going anywhere, and you're always just going to be left with, like, you know, the rope that was never long enough, or just feeling like, oh, this close to this goal or whatever with them, but you never actually get there. And I think it's so frustrating because, don't get me wrong, relationships take patience, right? Like everything else in life. And of course, nobody's perfect, and sometimes you just have to get to know each other and all that. So I think it's hard to tell when you're falling for someone's potential in the beginning. But I think if after a while, like, let's even start with something as early as dating, right? Because I think we talked about the situationships before, where, you know, if you're both deciding from the very beginning that you do want to date, you know, but let's take it slow and see what happens and blah, 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 and eventually we'll get here. Well, how long is eventually to you? And what does that mean getting into the relationship together and stuff? Like, you, these are things you have to think about, because even though they seem so small in the beginning, they eventually do add up, and you have to ask yourself, like, how long do I wait for this person? Because, yeah, that potential of that relationship that is on the horizon isn't guaranteed. So if that person is just stringing you along and stuff, there is that potential of like, oh, well, I could see myself with this person, blah, blah. But can they see themselves with you? That's that question.
Yeah, like, are they just using you to learn and to level up? Sometimes people will just use you because, you know, you are motivating, you are comforting, you know? And I think situationships, the foundation of a situationship is potential. Let's be real. That's really what fuels it, because I think that's why people get caught up and stay in them for so long. I've been guilty of it. It's because that's the leading thing, that, like, that, you know, something that you think you're gonna get when you don't even end up getting it. And I want to go deeper too, like, you know, even, you know, going off relationships, even family, you know, we could have potential in certain family members, you know, like wanting them to level up, do more for themselves, but in the day they're gonna do for themselves what they want to do. You know, you can be there, you could tell them, you could be an inspiration, but I've learned to, like, take a step back and let people make their own mistakes and grow as well, you know, because I think when we're stretching ourselves thin, trying to help them, trying to push them, they don't even want to, because we're seeing their potential. You only end up hurting yourself, you know. You end up pouring from an empty glass, because, and then you get frustrated with them.
That's
because they're not stepping up into the potential that you see.
Ooh, that's big facts, honestly. With potential, you're carrying most of the weight of the relationship or whatever the situation is. And like Vernisa was saying, with family, everything too, like you're carrying more of those expectations, and you're probably doing more of the work too. So in that sense, you're only hurting yourself with potential. You're only leading yourself to your own potential heartbreak, because, yeah, carrying that weight while still carrying your own is so hard. Like, I've been there, I've done that, where there's certain family members that I'm like, come on, like, I want to see you succeed and everything. But if they're not in that headspace to get out of the situation they're in, whatever they're struggling with, I can't do that for them. And I've noticed when I do, I'm really just, you know, carrying their problems as if they were my own. And that's not fair to yourself. And I think potential plays a big factor. A big factor in that, where you just feel like you have to do this for this person, and even though you want the best for them, like, you got to realize when you're spreading yourself too thin, and you just got to be like, you know what, I can't do this for you, I can't carry your weight for you, because I'm only gonna hurt myself.
Yeah, I like to even look at the flip side. You know, there's been times, I'm pretty sure all of us have been the person where someone seen the potential in us and we weren't living up to it. I think about when someone was trying to push me and I wasn't ready to make those changes, I didn't realize how much I was hurting them, or like weighing down on them because I wasn't facing myself. But now, you know, but guess what? It took me to take that snap of like, okay, I'm going to make this change. I'm going to live into my potential, live into my purpose, for it to happen. There's only so much that person could have done. So you have to think of it in that lens too, when we are the ones trying to help them.
Yeah, that's so true. And you end up pouring from an empty glass. I mean, if somebody's not pouring back into you, like, everything just ends up drying up. Like, really thinking about, you know, we always talk about how relationships are like plants or like flowers, whatever. You got to nurture them in order for them to continue thriving. But the thing is, it's a give and take, right? Like, you can't just keep pouring that water and then that flower's just sitting there and chilling and stuff. Like, y'all both got to be doing your part. And same thing, that flower's not going to thrive if you're not putting in that water, the food, the nutrients, everything. So it's the same thing with relationships. But when you're the only one doing the pouring, like, what about you? You know, relationships are supposed to be reciprocated. I know it's not always supposed to be 50-50, that sometimes people struggle more and everything, but at the same time, there always has to be a give and take. Like, it can never just be give, 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 and then what? You know, it's hard.
It's hard, yeah. We have to continue, you know, nurturing ourselves as well. Another thing we enjoy want to make clear is, don't lie to yourself as well. Like, I think when we're, especially with dating relationships, when we're falling for somebody who we see only their potential, we lie to ourselves. We're like, we try to, like, convince ourselves that it's right, you know, even though we know, like, we deserve better. Yeah. We try to convince it. And, you know, one of the other signs is, yeah, if you have to sugarcoat the situation, then, yeah, that is a sign you're falling for potential. Because I feel like I've been guilty of that, like, dealing with somebody I shouldn't have, but I, like, sugarcoat it, like, to my friends and, like, to people, I would sugarcoat how the person was or like making that seem so bad. And then it's like later, it's like, oh yeah, actually this was going on, you know? And we all been guilty of that, but that was me falling for potential or like trying to mold this person to who I hope they would be.
Mm-hmm. That's the thing. I've for sure.
You lied if you say you ain't did that.
Yes. Oh my gosh. I've been so guilty of that. Or also realizing that just because I feel that way about that person doesn't mean they necessarily do, mm-hmm. right? So even if, like, let's say they took me out to a fancy dinner or whatever, to them it may just be food, you know, before the closeout or whatever, but for me it might be like, oh my gosh, he took me on a date, you know, it's so nice, like he has that potential of boyfriend material or whatever. I was just lying to myself. Like, let's be real. And it sucks because you don't ever want to think that you're doing that to yourself, you know. I remember in those times when I was with that specific person, like I really thought we were headed somewhere, so I would put up with whatever he was feeding me. Like if he would take me out, I would be like, oh my gosh, look. And yeah, I would come home and tell like my mom, you know, my best friend. I would be like, oh yeah, you know, we went out and stuff, knowing dang well it was like our first date in like 3 months or whatever, you know. And it just wasn't actually going anywhere. We weren't having like solid, meaningful conversations and actually having intention with our dating. So I really was lying to myself in that aspect and really just hurting myself. But you don't think about it that way, because sometimes while you're living in those emotions and the rose-colored glasses, you want to believe it's real. And it is for you. It's just for the other person, they may not see it the way that you do. So again, we go back to like, you know, intentional and everything when you're dating somebody. But just don't lie to yourself. If it doesn't feel right, if you have to sugarcoat it, it's probably not the best situation for yourself.
Yeah, and I think one of the reasons we sugarcoat too is because we're like kind of afraid to what our friends are gonna say, mm-hmm. like when they're, because let's be real, like your friend who's outside of the situation, they see the situation for what it is because they're not in it. Think about, we're in a situation, we're emotionally invested, so we're literally seeing that tunnel vision of what we see. Oh, how I felt, oh, then his smile, whatever. You know, it's real, I'm being honest. Like, that's the thing, me and Jim transparent on here. We ain't sugarcoating on here. Yeah. We've been through it. So what I'm trying to say is, you know, our friends see everything. So, of course, they're going to give us that tough love, mm-hmm. of like, you know, a girl, I noticed this, or, you know, maybe, you know, they're going to question it. You know, you got some people who are haters, too, mm-hmm. who are trying to just make you feel like shit about a situation. Like, even if you're happy, they'll try to find a way to. We're not talking about that. We're talking about your real friends who tell you the real, who are going to give you that real tough love. And I think sometimes that's why we sugarcoat, because we don't want to hear the truth or hear that, you know, the guy really does have malintentions, or he's not, or we're just seeing their potential. Mm-hmm. So another thing is like, don't be afraid to let your friends give you that tough, your real friends who tell you the real, those who I'm talking about, to give you tough love. Because in a day, I've learned to accept that, you know. I used to ignore, like, I used to ignore the tough love. I used to think, oh, whatever, they, you know, I'm gonna go through it myself. I used to type, I gotta burn my hand on the stove myself.
Guilty.
And it gets me in trouble every time, you know. But as I've been like coming into myself, coming to the person I'm supposed to be, I'm learning to accept that. Like when my friends tell me some real advice, I'm like, okay, let me really listen to what they're saying, mm-hmm. and use discernment, and, you know, and taking and understand their perspective before trying to hush them, because I'm like, oh, you know, I don't want the guy to seem like such a bad person, when really, or not even a bad person, but that I'm just seeing through their potential.
Yeah, exactly. Because we want to make it clear, obviously, seeing somebody's potential, we're not saying it makes them a bad person, they ain't really this person. If you see a potential in somebody, it's because clearly they have some sort of characteristics that you like, you're vibing with, whatever. But when that's all it is, that's when it becomes the problem, you know. And we're not saying seeing somebody's potential is the worst thing in the world, or like, you know, F that person, don't ever deal with them. That's not what we're saying at all. We're just saying you got to take into account your feelings, your time, your energy, and everything. So yeah, like when we're trying to sugarcoat the entire situation, our friends are giving us that tough love, we're not trying to hear that, right? Because we're already trying to deal with it on our own, trying to see how I feel about it. And then if I have somebody else's words in my ear, then of course I'm going to start questioning things. But sometimes we need that. That's like a wake-up call. Mm-hmm. And same thing, I've learned to start accepting that tough love, because sometimes when things are so under our noses, we don't see them.
We don't.
So when at least somebody from the outside is starting to give us those possible solutions, or, you know, hey, have you ever thought that maybe he's not taking you seriously or whatever? It hurts. Don't get me wrong. Like, tough love doesn't get easier to accept the older you get or anything. The thing is, when people have like your back and they really want to see you succeed in relationships and everything, you need to start taking that, because it's not going to be easy, but in the long run it's going to be for your best. Like, when these people care about you, they have your best intentions in mind.
In a day, they're trying to protect you, you know. And sometimes your friend's been through it already. So they're just trying to help you foreseeing something that they already been through, you know. And I had to learn that the hard way as well. And also, too, like Mama always said, when somebody show you their true colors, don't ignore them. So what we're trying to say is pay attention to the red flags as they appear. That's a way to catch the potential thing. Because I'm going to be real, that potential sometimes is so strong that, yeah, they'll do something shady or, you know, whatever, and we ignore because we're like, oh, well, he could be this person or he could change. It's not, I'm not saying people are perfect. I'm not saying look for a perfect person, but I'm saying like those big red flags that we choose to ignore because we all that probably have done it, you know, and we use that potential as like that little free card for them to like a little pass to get, you know, to get by.
For sure. Also, I'm just going to say I've been guilty this whole
episode. Yeah, this episode is a diary.
I am now realizing the mistakes I have made.
Okay. You grow. Look, that's why we up here talking, because we can speak on it. We all homegirls helping y'all foreseeing some things. Go ahead, though.
But damn, I have put myself through some things. Whew, Lord. But yeah, like, I remember when I was dating this one person, I knew how I felt about them, and I knew I wanted to be with them in the long run, but I started ignoring the red flags from the very beginning. Like in the first 2 months that we were dating, I would notice he would bring me down about my job at the time, the way I was dressing, like even the food I was choosing to eat. And don't get me wrong, it helped me in the sense of like getting myself back on track with fitness, you know, and finances and stuff. But I didn't realize those were like backhanded comments too. And those were red flags I shouldn't have ignored, because then, yeah, as the relationship progressed, the comments just got worse and worse throughout time. Like, he would really start attacking my self-image and just making me feel worse about myself. Like, why are you still at this job when you did this and blah, 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 and all this. So those things show up in the very beginning. I'm not saying everybody shows their true colors from the very beginning, but you'll notice certain things, right? I've always heard that the first thing you argue about in your relationship is the thing you'll always argue about. So pay attention to what that argument is, because if it's a huge red flag that, you know, like, is a blow up in the first place, that should be your cue that maybe you're falling for their potential, or maybe you're just trying to see the relationship through these rose-colored lenses that you shouldn't be seeing. Like, we need to really just hit ourselves with reality and face the truth that not everybody's for us, and that's okay. But we save ourselves a lot of time when we realize we're falling for somebody's potential.
It's true. I mean, at time I fell for somebody's potential. Like, I remember there was a dude, he was pursuing me for a while, and he gave me this whole speech rundown on how, like, he went in, got his temper. I've been wanting you. You know, he was, like, serious. Like, I was sitting there like, all right, shoot. Like, you know, I'm a good guy. I've been wanting you. Gave me a whole B2K moment, right? I'm like, okay, hold up, you know. Look, this is my naive days, by the way. But what I want to say is, like, you know, it was other aspects of him, too, that were charming, that were, you know, he's real smart, all kind of stuff. But what I want to say is, like, when I started dealing with him, once things hit the fan, like, things got real between us, like, you know, certain situations, you know, his true colors came out. Like, literally the type of person that he is. And I realized it was all a facade. And it's like, you know, don't be surprised when the facade comes down when you're dealing with someone's potential. Because, like, I based it, my feelings towards him, because of his potential. Because, like, you know, he showed me he was growing. He was trying to do all these things and stuff, which is great. But at the end of the day, like, it ain't really who you are. Because once it was time for your heart, your soul to show how genuine a person you are, he wasn't there. You know, he wasn't the person, you know. So sometimes, too, they'll use that outer exterior. But I really think what a message trying to give here, too, look into someone's soul. Look at how genuine a person. Look at their loyalty. You know, look at them when think it's easy for a person to act cool with you when shit's going right. Like, yeah, they're getting their way. Y'all happy. Things are cool. But what about when there's a heart and there's a storm between y'all? How are they going to act? Are they going to fold when you really need them for something? How are they going to really act? And I think those are the moments, too, when you'll know if someone's potential is what is the thing that's keeping the relationship together.
Facts. Pay very close attention when you are down, who's kicking you and who's actually trying to bring you back up.
Because oh my goodness,
those are your signs for sure. And you can't think you can save people, you know. Once that facade does come down and you start seeing those red flags, don't put yourself in hero mode and be like, oh, well, I know I can change them, or I know if I show them I love them enough, my love's gonna be enough. I want to make this clear. I am a huge believer in romance. I love love and everything, but I have seen that you can love someone to death. You can love somebody with your whole heart and soul. If they don't want to change, if they don't want to love you back, if they don't want to be there, they are not going to do anything. And we need to be putting that into our heads, because we're only hurting ourselves when we're doing this. I didn't realize how much I actually poured of myself into this person when I tried saving our relationship and, you know, trying to see, oh, well, if he sees I'm a good woman, I can prove to him that I'm the best he had or whatever. I was so broken at the end of that relationship. Like, I had put my entire identity into it that I didn't realize how much I lost myself. And once I finally got out, I had to find out who the hell is Jen at this point. And, you know, it helped me in the long run. It helped me become who I am. I feel like I needed that heartbreak to wake up. But if I could have saved myself from that extreme of, you know, those feelings, I would definitely have done it. I would have gone back to myself and told myself, Jen, wake up. This is a red flag. This is that potential. You cannot save this person.
Mm-hmm. And they too, like you guys, they have to want to save themselves. You know, I think the more we try to save someone and they don't want to save themselves, we're just walking on pins and needles. We're stretching ourselves thin. We're wearing ourselves out, you know, and I think that's the main thing. And also, too, the more we sit here trying to put energy into trying to help, you know, help someone else's potential, we're stunting our own potential. Mm-hmm. You know, we're stunting our own growth, because all that energy we're using on them, we'd be pouring that back into ourselves. But, you know, that, and I think that's why, like, in certain relationships, you know, we do end up losing ourselves, because it's like we'll forget about our needs and dreams or whatever, yeah, trying to, like I said, save the other person. And I think once we put it onto perspective, everyone's actively doing their own work that they need to be doing, it wouldn't be a hassle like that. Mm-hmm. Something wrong with guidance, passing wisdom, knowledge, and helping them, but they have to be one to help themselves, and they have to be pouring into you too as well. Like, you know, it's kind of have to go both ways.
Yeah, because think about it, relationships take energy, time, mm-hmm, and everything. So the more you're pouring that energy and time of yours into somebody else, you're lacking to work on yourself, whether it is your own goals, your own potential, whatever, because you're so busy trying to save this other person, trying to bring their own potential out. So let's say you actually get there, right? Let's say you actually get to save them, quote unquote, and they become this magnificent person. After that, they don't owe you anything. Mm-hmm. So if they leave, or they feel like, well, now she's not enough or whatever, because I've leveled up or whatever, I'm not saying this makes it right, but it can happen. You spend so much time. Yeah. You spend so much time building this person up. You forgot to build your own self up. So if this person leaves, what are you left with? Mm-hmm. Always, always, always keep your identity outside of your relationships. Keep yourself, mm-hmm, in mind, who you are, who you want to be, what you're working forward towards, because nobody owes you anything. If somebody decides to stop messing with you tomorrow, that's on them, you know. But at the end of the day, you got to save you. You got to think about yourself. Always, always be building your potential up, because you're the only one living your own life. And if you're neglecting it, who's building you up?
That's so true. Like, I mean, you see it all the time. You see it in the movies or in real time, people building the other person up in their relationship, and then they end up, like, that person walk off with the shoes, you know, just whatever. It just, that's it. And it's like, no.
For real.
Like, you always have your own. Always, you know, take care of yourself. And then they too, you can see a person's potential, but it doesn't mean that they see it, you know. And you can get them to see it, whatever. But if they ain't trying to do anything, do the inner work, I think just leave it as, let them figure it out.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely. When you're seeing somebody's potential through your own lens and your own assumptions, how you want them to be, you're also missing getting to know them. Mm. And it can go both ways, right? In the sense of seeing those red flags or that they're not compatible with you, but then also seeing how wonderful somebody can be. Because if we just paint this person to be, mm-hmm, a certain picture that we want them to be, yeah, we're missing out everything that they come with. They may be trying to teach us something, but we're so busy over here seeing that type of potential that we want them to have because we want a certain future for them. What if they're not meant for that future, you know? Or what if they're only meant to be for a season in our lives and that was their potential at that moment, but we're so busy trying to look into the future that we're missing the moment right now. So don't ever try to just mold somebody into what you want them to be or anything, because you never know what that person comes with, whether it's good or bad. There's always a lesson or a blessing in everything.
Yeah, honestly, a person being unique is so beautiful. I can't tell you how many times, like, I've met dudes and, like, yeah, I tried to put them in the, like, a different box, like, maybe if they were this, but it's like I'm missing out on, like, yeah, the tricks, that those traits, mm-hmm, that are beautiful about them, because, yeah, I'm so like, well, is it this way, like, trying to see the fixed way, mm-hmm, that I see it, you know. And also we want to say too, you know, don't take it personal when, let's say, you're dealing with somebody and you help them with their potential and they brought out those traits on somebody else. Don't take that person. It has nothing to do with you.
Girl.
Go ahead, girl. I know you're ready for that one.
Again, I've been guilty of this. With that same ex, like, I did notice that with his next relationship, he was very public about it. Like, on paper, it seemed like he was treating her better. He had become a quote-unquote better man for her and everything. And I had honestly taken that personally because I was like, well, what the hell, like, this is the potential I had seen in him, and you know, this is what I wanted from him and everything. And they had their own problems for whatever reason. They're not together anymore. But for me, I just had to stop internalizing it and realize that this has nothing to do with me. That if he became a better man for her, that's cool. You know, you want somebody to grow after dealing with you. You want to grow too after dealing with somebody. So I just wanted to put that out there. We wanted to put that out there because, yeah, like, I've been guilty of that, seeing my ex treat his current girlfriend better or whatever, but that has nothing to do with me. Like, there's a reason we broke up. We don't work out or anything, and now we're both in different headspaces. We're different people, right? And I'm hoping that maybe I brought some sort of lesson he needed, and that's why he stepped up as a man, or this is just a phase that he wanted to go through, and now he is a better person. So just don't ever take it personally if somebody does level up or whatever after you. Be your own level up. Like, be the love you wanted to receive from that person instead.
Mm-hmm. And honestly, sometimes we are meant to bless people too. I'm gonna throw that in there. Yes. Like, sometimes people are you are meant to cross paths with people so you could teach them something, you could learn from them. I have learned that, you know, like, and you know, and that's okay too. Like, you know, life is full of lessons, you know. And sometimes we weren't meant for someone, but whatever we taught them was gonna help them later. And same with us, you know, because I feel like even though we talk about these situations we've been in, you know, we became stronger women from certain things, you know, and there was a lesson in those hidden for us, you know. So it's all the same thing, you know. And in the day, like, I feel like there's no real foundation with potential. It's only hopes. If you think about it, what is potential really sitting on, you know? So keep that in mind too. Whenever, like, if you're catching yourself with a partner or like someone you're trying to motivate and it's only hopes, like nothing in the reality is coming to surface, like they're not even making no progress towards anything. Yeah, most likely you're dealing with someone with just potential, like only because of potential.
Yeah. And think about how strong your relationship could really be if that's all it is. Mm-hmm. Just hopes. Like, you, how can you and I sit here and say, oh, well, I hope we become this type of person for each other, and I hope, you know, I'm her best friend in this way and blah, blah, blah. Like, that, just living with that uncertainty isn't strong. And let's be real, when there's only hopes, you still have a lot of those insecurities of like, well, maybe it'll lead to this, maybe this, maybe that, and all those questions. You're not enjoying the relationship. And instead, we need to see a relationship for what it is, whether it is good, whether it is bad. Like, you need to be able to give yourself that tough love also and tell yourself, you know what, yeah, there's no real foundation to this. Like, we can't have anything further than this because either we both don't want it, or one of us wants it too much, the other not enough, whatever. Like, we just really need to tell ourselves, I know that there's no foundation, so there's actually no future to this.
Mm-hmm. And it is just potential. Mm-hmm. And I think, obviously, to avoid all this, it just starts with what? Loving yourself first. Loving yourself first, because I feel like when you love yourself wholeheartedly, you're not going to let nobody run your well dry, because you're going to know your limits. And then we're going to go deeper into this. You're going to know when to be patient and when not to be patient with somebody.
Yeah. And I know that statement, like, everybody hears that, right? Like, you got to love yourself first and blah, blah. And we really stay true to that, though. You know, as much as I've heard that throughout my life, I was like, come on, like, everybody says that, you know, give me something more concrete. But it's true. Because it even goes with that quote that says, we accept the love we think we deserve. At the end of the day, we put up with whatever we think we deserve in that moment. Whether you want to admit it to yourself or not, whatever you're dealing with right now, whether it's good or bad, you feel like you deserve that moment. And if those insecurities are coming in saying, you know what, I want better, I want more, listen to that. There's a reason your intuition is telling you that you don't want to deal with this or anything, but it comes with that love that you're giving to yourself. Again, you can't love somebody all wholeheartedly unless you love yourself there. We can only meet people where they're at, right? But we can only meet ourselves where we're at too. So when two people are trying to get together and trying to meet each other, you know, at a certain point, like, each person has to be whole enough to be able to come together. I'm not saying people can't grow together or anything, that potential can't build into anything, but don't bank on it. I'm huge on that you can't like expect somebody to change. You can't expect a relationship to get better if it's already been showing you that it's not. And I was, you know, very guilty of that, where I stopped loving myself for a long time just because I wanted to love somebody else harder. And it just made me realize how important self-love really is, and just mm-hmm. living by that quote of loving yourself first, because potential is a killer. But if you pour that love into yourself first, you're gonna save yourself a lot of heartbreak.
So true. And you'll know how long to be patient, or rather you're being patient with the wrong thing. Like, are they really doing the inner work? Is the potential, like you said, turning into something, mm-hmm. or is it just staying stagnant? You know, and I think when you love yourself, you'll know, like, okay, this ain't
yes.
it. You know, and honestly, all this relates to self-love, because what's the word? You're giving yourself what you deserve. Mm. I feel like we deserve more than just potential. So you're setting your standards high, you know, for you, you know, because I think when we just fall for potential, we're lowering our stuff. And I'm guilty of that. I've done it, you know, and I think being in that space and then being how I see it now, I'm like, yeah, I'd rather take this route mm-hmm. versus the potential route, only solely potential route.
Yes. Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
When I say potential in general, yeah.
That's right. And you deserve someone who can match your efforts and your reality.
Yeah.
We just want to put that out there. Like, it's okay to wait, or it's okay to say, I don't want this, or walk away from something, as scary as it is. Like, if you deep down feel like it's not right, like something else has to come along, again, speaking on solely potential with somebody, that's all they're giving you, walk away. It's fine. Like, I've said this before, I am intentionally single for that purpose, because I know that I don't want to settle for anything less. I've been through potential. I've given somebody a benefit of the doubt. I've tried loving someone hard enough past their potential. I've tried building somebody else up while, you know, forgetting about myself in the moment. I've done all of these X, Y, and Z's, but for what? Like, it hasn't done me any justice. You know, at the end of the day, these people, yeah, they didn't owe me anything. No one asked me to do this for them or whatever. So before y'all come to me saying, you know, well, you shouldn't have done this, blah, blah. At the end of the day, when you love somebody and you want the best for them, yeah, you're going to try and pump them up. You're going to try and get them better, you know, and seeing that they actually fulfilled themselves to their potential that you see, while also letting them grow. But don't ever forget about yourself, and just really remember that whatever effort you're putting in, you deserve that back. Every relationship has to be 100-100, right? It ain't 50-50. And yeah, sometimes things are gonna get harder, where you give more, they take more, etc., vice versa and everything. But it always has to be that they are wanting you to grow and are putting that effort into you growing as much as you are into them.
Yeah, and I think those some questions you need to ask yourself when dealing with someone is, do their values align with yours? Are your needs being met? You know, I think we forget to ask that because we're so caught up in like trying to do for them and making sure we're a match for their box. But are they fitting in your box? I had to ask myself that, because I caught my, you know, back in my days when I used to like was seeking more validation, I would try to fit correctly into whatever they were asking for, but then I was forgetting what I needed and what I wanted out of it, you know. Shoot, I need to ask myself that now.
Ask, y'all, we going through it.
Ask yourself those questions, you know, and when you ask yourself, I feel like that'll bring clarity right there, you know, just to start. What's the other question we was thinking? Oh, and also, how do you emotionally feel around this person? You know, like, do you feel triggered? Do you feel happy? Do you feel at peace? Like, all those things are things that you know, that you need to play out.
Yeah. I think another question, too, is it your potential or is it theirs?
Woo!
Right? Mm-hmm. Like we said, sometimes we want something for somebody, but then we don't realize that we're either stunting their growth, stunting our own growth. So is it really the reality of them, or is it the reality of them we want them to be? Mm-hmm. And also just thinking, like, do you guys align in that aspect, even with your potential, right? So going off of the values thing, like, do you guys want the same future? Are you headed towards the same path? Because just because somebody's successful in one area and somebody is successful in another doesn't mean that they're going to align together. So just thinking about each other's potential and, like, what you want for your own future, what they may want for their own future, too. Because let's be real, falling for somebody's potential, you're just manipulating yourself. Mm-hmm. You're lying to yourself. You're making assumptions about this other person. You're thinking that this person's going to be a certain way when they may not want to, right? And we're just the ones continuously, well, why aren't they like this and blah, 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 just causing our own heartache in the process.
Yeah, and they were putting ourselves on an emotional roller coaster, mm-hmm. because guess what? They're going to keep disappointing you, yeah. and then you're going to get mad at yourself and them, and then it's just work. And then you catch yourself like, well, I've been with this person. Well, you know what I mean? And we owe ourselves more than that, you know, and I think Yeah, that was good that you brought that up. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I want to say, too, have tough love with yourself. Sometimes we got to get real with ourselves. Like, man, this month, that month of just sitting and woo! Like, girl, yeah.
It's hard.
Trust me, it's not easy. But those real conversations where you're really talking to yourself, figuring out really what you want or, like, what you should be doing better, I think we all should have that. You know, obviously, don't attack yourself. Don't speak mm-hmm. mean to yourself. But just really, I'll say this, check in with yourself. You know, mm-hmm. I said this on our live episode that I started doing these little writings in a book, you know, checking in with myself. So like, literally writing out what obstacles am I facing? What do I need? You know, what am I proud of myself for? I think, you know, if you doing that, it will help. You know, if you really need to write about the person that you're dealing with, like, okay, what do I like about this person? Don't I like? Or, like, what is missing? You know, and, you know, whatever it takes, I think you have to get real with yourself at the end of the day.
Oh, yeah, for sure. You'll know.
Yeah, you'll know. We know. It's something, it's always a voice in the yes. background saying, you know, we know. We choose to not listen to that voice. Mm-hmm.
And that's the thing. Man. It's hard, right? Yeah, it's hard not. Giving yourself that tough love. It's, first of all, it's hard receiving that tough love from somebody else. So you trying to give it to yourself, it sucks, right? And sometimes you don't want to deal with the questions. You don't want to sit down and write stuff. But I'm going to say this from personal experience. If you don't do it, you're going to end up wasting 6 months, 2 years, mm-hmm. 10 years of your life being with a potential.
Ooh,
hoping yeah, that it's going to be. Yes. Hoping that it's going to lead to somewhere. And like I said, I've been guilty of all of this. I wasted 6 months on somebody. I've wasted 2 years on somebody. Thankfully, I ain't wasted 10 years on nobody. But still, like, it was just me wasting all that time and energy just trying to make this work with somebody and everything. And I think the biggest conclusion I came to is you can't make someone do the inner work if they don't want to. If they're not ready for it, they just aren't at that phase. You gotta stop. Yo, I'm not saying you can't encourage somebody, you can't try and teach them something, but if they don't want to take it, stop wasting your energy. Mm-hmm. Stop wasting your time. We need to stop wasting our own potential on somebody else's potential.
That's true. In the day, all you're doing is wearing yourself thin, mm-hmm. you know, and that's not fair to you. And all we gotta say is what? Don't fall for it. Like, do not fall for that potential.
Bro.
We appreciate y'all tapping into our 55th episode. We have a lot of exciting stuff coming soon. Check us out on Instagram at SpeakUpJV. Also, check us out on our other platforms. We're on Spotify, Apple, apparently our Heart Radio. We're on Podbean at SpeakUpJV.podbean.com. And what else was our other thing over our show going on?
Catch us live every Thursday at 7 p.m. only on the Good News Radio Network. Make sure you download the app so that you can chat with us. You can also call in on the show, but if you're on the app, you can just call in directly. In order to download the app, you can go to at the Good News Radio Instagram bio, and you'll see the link there to download it. But yeah, catch your girls Speak Up JV live and unfiltered Thursdays at 7.
Yes, we're excited to hear from you. We appreciate y'all tapping in.
Love y'all.
Love y'all.